Okay, so in this tutorial, I'm going to go over my brand new transform control preset. It's something that I came up with just to make my life a lot easier and to make my workflow a lot more streamlined and effective. And I figured someone else may find some use for this. So this works with any layer, but the easiest way to show it is with a text layer. So I'm just going to type in my name real quick. Click on that and see our anchor point is here at the bottom. I can go ahead and center that up real quick. Say if I added another line. Click on that and see our anchor point is right here and we're no longer centered. We have to go through and do a few keystrokes to get it centered back again. But I wanted to come up with a way that was even quicker. The way you're going to install this is go to your documents, Adobe, whatever version you're using. I'm in 2023, user presets, and you can see I have it right here, transform control. But you can drop this anywhere inside of user presets and it will show up in After Effects. Now, depending on where you put it, is going to dictate where it shows up in your effects and presets. Okay, so underneath my 7-minute AE, here is my transform control preset. So all you have to do is select the layer and then double click the preset. And as you can see, your anchor point is immediately centered and the text snaps to the center of your comp. Normally to get to all of your transform properties, you would need shortcuts like P for position. If you hold down shift, you can select A for anchor point, S for scale, T for opacity, R for rotation. So 5 keystrokes right there are going to be saved out of the gate. Everything you need is at the layer level right here. So just going from top to bottom, let's check out our anchor point control. If you click down that drop down, you can see that you have all 9 options, top left, top center, top right, mid, and then bottom. And it goes from left to right on all of these. It's going to default to mid center, but you can change this to anything that you would like. And it's also going to default on your position, 960 by 540. So the one thing to keep in mind is that if you start off with a 1080 by 1080 comp, for example, if you're doing like a 1x1, you may need to adjust this. You can control your position right here and you can even keyframe things. So say if you wanted to do just like a really quick position animation, for example, you still have that ability to do that. And then going on down, we have our scale control, which is just a basic scale control. It's going to default to 100%, just like it does at the layer level. Make some adjustments there, and you can see what you can do with the scale control. Before moving on, I just want to take a minute to tell you about some of the templates I've been creating to make your life a lot easier. Create lower thirds in the blink of an eye with my Luminatrix lower thirds templates, powered by Essential Graphics, so you can use these templates in both After Effects and Premiere. You also want to check out my Text Animator Toolkit. It's also powered by Essential Graphics, so you can easily animate text in both After Effects and Premiere. Check out the link in the description below for access to presets for virtually everything you could possibly want or need. Text to shape layers, snow effects, text boxes, text animators, shape layer accents like burst and animated circles, and so much more. Check out courses, templates, project files, and ways to get personalized coaching from my new School of AE. Now, let's get back to the tutorial. Our rotation and skew kind of go together. You can use them independently if you want, but you can rotate maybe -5 degrees and then skew this, say 10, and get like a really cool skewed look. But you don't have to use them at the same time. You can just skew or you can just affect the rotation. But I wanted to include the skew option because a lot of times I'll do that on my own text animations. I may kind of offset the rotation a little bit, increase the skew, so you have that option. So the last transform property is opacity. It's going to fade your layer in and out based on your in and out points. Good about maybe 2 seconds and then trim that. So these fades require no keyframes, which is kind of cool. All you have to do is just put in the number of keyframes you want to fade in and out. For example, a 10 frame fade in and a 10 frame fade out. Watch that play back and we have our fade in and our fade out. Now, of course, you can use different values here, and you can even make the fade in and out different lengths. So say, for example, we want a 15-frame fade in, but we want a 1-second fade out. And there are no keyframes, which is super cool, and this also kind of helps you to remember to trim your layers. This last thing down here, do not delete. It's some background coding. It's not something that needs to be altered. Now, one of the things that's really cool about this also is that this does not affect text animators. So I'm going to set my opacity fading back to 0 so that way there's no fade. These are some custom made text animators. If I want to do a 3D character random blur, I'm just going to select my layer and then double click that. The text still remains centered at 960 by 540. These expressions do not affect text animators. We're still right in the middle, and you can actually go back over here and move this to wherever you want and retain that animation. So this is my transform control preset. It's something that I use quite a bit, mainly to speed up my workflow and allows me to stay focused on my creativity and creating really cool animations without having to worry about a lot of the technical things like centering anchor points every single time, moving my position and things like that. Grab this preset from the link in the description below, give it a shot, and leave me a message in the comments to tell me if you find this preset useful, how it's working for you, and if this is something that has sped up your workflow as much as it has mine. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.
I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com.